Okay, this week, the people who created Vicuna released a really nice tool that I thought I'd just make a quick post about. And this is the Chat Arena that they've got here. So this is the team that made Vicuna. They've got a nice blog just talking about different things that they're doing, different projects they're doing. And here they've basically created this chatbot arena for benchmarking LLMs. And really it's aimed at benchmarking the results of LLMs in the wild. So not using traditional academic testings and benchmarks for that kind of thing. It's really just getting the models themselves against each other, and then people can sort of decide for this. So if we click into the chatbot arena, you'll see that there's a number of different things in here. So first off, you can, you know, one of the first things that you can do is you can actually select two models to compare them yourself. Let's say you've got a set of prompts that are for a particular domain and you want to be able to know which kind of model is best for this. This is something that's really interesting to check out, is that here I've selected the koala model and the Vicuna model. And you can see in here, what I've basically asked them to do is tell me a story about a cat called Max, who was shrewd and cunning. And it basically sends it off at the same time to both models. They write a story, and then I can read both of the stories and go through them. I can decide which one I think is better. In this case, I think probably the koala one is better at the storytelling. So I'm going to register a vote for that one. And then I can go through them. I can look at that. And then I can benchmark other models. So if I want to come up here, I could benchmark koala against the Open Assistant model. So unfortunately, they don't have every model that's out there. This is the Open Assistant Pythia model. They don't have the 30 billion llama version of that. But they do have like the alpaca, 13 billion, again from llama. The original llama model itself is good for you to play with and just see, okay, what it's like. The stable LM model, remember, this is not a finished trained model. This is still got a long way to go from where they were. We've got the Dolly model. So it allows us to compare a lot of these different models and see what's going on here. And, you know, this is a fantastic sort of thing. Now, this probably voting like this is not a great thing. So the next thing up that they've got is where you can actually have a chatbot arena, where here these models are anonymous, and I've basically asked them, describe how we get energy at a cellular level. So I just come down here, I put my prompt in here, I click send, and we can see one of the models has said, well, at a cellular level, energy is provided by breakdown of molecules to glucose, which releases ATP. Okay, that is quite nice and succinct. Here we've got a much longer answer. Now, this will depend. Do I want a lot of information, or do I want, you know, something that's succinct in this case? My guess is this is probably a Vicuna model or a koala model. This is definitely giving a more detailed one. So we'll go for this one, right? So let's say we say B is better in this case. It will basically tell us, oh, okay, so that was the original alpaca model, and this was the Open Assistant Pythia model there. So that's kind of interesting to look at. And then we could do another one in here. If we, you know, came in, put in another prompt, and here we could go through it and do that. The next thing up is you can actually look at the leaderboard. And so they've got a leaderboard where they're calculating an ELO rating. So this is similar to how people calculate chess ratings. Here they've got this ELO score going on, and we can see what are the top models in here. We can see what their ratings are. And I'm hoping that they're going to update this over time. So I would encourage all of you to come in here, do a number of these chatbot arena ones, get sort of, if you could do 5-10 of these, that's going to then really give them a lot of data to be able to work out really what's the leader. At the moment, Vicuna is the leader. They're the one, they're the guys who created Vicuna. I'm not sure if this is biased in any way or not. I noticed Koala is number two. Koala is certainly one of the models that I thought was the best out there. Koala and Vicuna have been really good. Unfortunately, they don't have things like stable Vicuna here. They don't have some of the newer models like Wizard LM or some of the sort of more unusual fine tunings of some of these things. But at least it gives us a way to sort of benchmark exactly how much better some of these models are. So it's very interesting to see, like, we know that this model and this model cannot be used for commercial use, but this model can. So in some ways, this is also telling us that this model is the current, you know, leader of a commercial use chatbot or a free ChatGPT, open source ChatGPT alternative in this case. Also the ChatGLM, so this is a model that I like quite a bit as well. I've never really looked at Fast Chat before, so I will definitely go and after this, go and look at this Fast Chat T5 model. That's quite nice and small. If that performs pretty well, we could even just come in here and choose that we want to do a test with that. If I come in here and just pick the ones that I want to do a test with, if I say, okay, the Fast Chat on that side, and let's pick Vicuna on this side. Actually, let's pick the Open Assistant on this side. And then we'll come in and we'll ask it, what were the main events? Okay, and you see that it's gone off, it's started processing. We can see that our prompt has gone into both of these. It's a great tool for just letting you test out the different models and see which ones do you think are best, which ones do you think are worth following up with. So we can see also the speed of some of these. So World One, I don't think really was a main event of World War Two in there. So that hasn't done a great job of that. Although it's got some parts of, you know, the key thing. All right, I think I'm going to give it a tie, because while it had some inaccuracies or gave us some sort of not useful information at the start, it certainly made up for it a lot more than this one, but just gave us a list of things. Now, this is all preference, right? You could argue that actually, no, this one is more concise and to the point, and, you know, it really comes down to personal opinion. That's why I would say for this kind of thing, come in and do it. The more people that do it, the more we will get a score and a leaderboard of, like, actually what is really useful out there. So let's just go back to the leaderboard. So we've got the Elo scores. You can also come down here and you can actually see the matchup of certain models versus other certain models too. So that's quite nice to be able to sort of see, like, okay, how well did a model do against other models? We can see how many times they've actually been benchmarked and stuff like that. The numbers here are still pretty low from what I'm seeing. So it would be great to get a lot of people coming in here testing this, and hopefully, you know, in the next week or so, they update all these scores so that we can see, you know, how the models actually do over time. That would be something to get a good sense about. Anyway, they also give you a notebook. If you want to come in here, you can go into the notebook and calculate what's going on, so you can actually get access to the data yourself. You can have a play with it. Overall, I just wanted to say, come in and test out some of these models. It's a great place for testing out models and trying things out, but then contribute to the actual chatbot arena battle by running some of your favorite prompts and seeing, okay, what, you know, models did you find to be the best? And you could actually just keep running the same prompt with different models too. That's something that you could do. This one is fully double blind, whereas the other one is not. So this is probably the one you want to go and try out a bit more. Anyway, as always, if you've got any questions or comments, please put them in the comments below. If you like this video, please click like and subscribe. I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.